Hello everyone, this is Arvind Egireddy. In this video, I'll be talking about surface area of right circular cylinders. We are covering this topic from NCERT class 9 syllabus, which is from chapter 13. Now, let us see what is meant by right circular cylinder. A right circular cylinder is a cylinder that has a closed circular surface having two parallel bases on both the ends and whose elements are perpendicular to its base. It is also called as right cylinder. So here we need to understand why we are calling it as right circular cylinder. Because a cylinder whose base is a circle is called circular cylinder. If the axis of the cylinder is perpendicular to its base, then the cylinder is called as an right circular cylinder, like what is being shown in this figure 13.6. Now let us see what kind of cylinders are not a right circular cylinder. So here we see a cylinder which is certainly circular, but it is not a right angle to the base. So we cannot say this as an right circular cylinder. Of course, if we have a cylinder with a non-circular base, as you see in the figure 13.7b, then also we cannot call it as an right circular cylinder. So here we will be dealing with only right circular cylinders. So unless stated otherwise, the word cylinder would mean it as an right circular cylinder. Now, if a cylinder is to be covered with a colored paper, how will we do it with the minimum amount of paper? First, we need to take a rectangular sheet of paper whose length is just enough to go round the cylinder and whose breadth is equal to the height of the cylinder, like shown in this particular figure. So here, the area of the sheet gives us the curved surface area of the cylinder. We need to note that the length of the sheet, which is equal to the circumference of the circular base, which is equal to 2 pi r, that is pi d. So, curved surface area of the cylinder will be equal to the area of the rectangular sheet, that is equal to length into breadth, where the length is the perimeter of the base of the cylinder, and into breadth. So that is perimeter of the base of the cylinder into height, which is equal to 2 pi r into h. Therefore, the curved surface area of the cylinder is equal to 2 pi r h, where r is the radius of the base of the cylinder and h is the height of the cylinder. Now, the total surface area of the cylinder with radius r and height h is equal to the curved surface area and the circular areas of the top and bottom cylinders, like what we see in this particular figure. So here the total surface area is equal to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square, because the area of the circle is pi r square and we have two such circles, one on the top and the other on the bottom. Therefore, the total surface area is equal to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square, which is equal to 2 pi r into r plus h. So the total surface area of a cylinder is equal to 2 pi r of r plus h, where h is the height of the cylinder and r is the radius of the cylinders. Now let us go into the exercise problems. So let us go with the first problem. The curved surface area of a right circular cylinder of height 14 centimeters is 88 centimeters square. We need to find the diameter of the base of the cylinder. So in this particular problem, we are being given with height as 14 centimeters and the curved surface area as 88 centimeters. And we need to find the diameter of the base. So let us represent the height with h, which is equal to 14 centimeters, and let us suppose the radius of the cylinder be r. And given the curved surface area of the cylinder is equal to 88 centimeters. That is 2 pi r h is equal to 88 centimeters square. Now substituting the values of pi as 22 by 7, h as 14 centimeters, if we solve the problem, we get r is equal to 1 centimeter. Now we need to find the value of the diameter, which is twice the radius. Therefore, diameter is equal to 2 into radius, that is 2 into 1 is equal to 2 centimeters. Therefore, the diameter of the base of the cylinder is 2 centimeters. Now let us go to the second problem. It is required to make a closed cylindrical tank of height 1 meter and base diameter 140 centimeters from a metal sheet. How many square meters of the sheets are required for the same? So here in the second problem, we need to make a closed cylindrical tank of height 1 meter and base diameter 140 centimeters. Now we need to calculate how much sheet is required to make this closed cylinder. So we need to find the total surface area of the in meter square. So here, given the height is 1 meter and the radius of the cylinder tank is equal to diameter by 2, that is 140 centimeters by 2 is equal to 70 centimeters. Now we need to find the area in meter square. So we need to convert centimeters to meters. For that, what we need to do? We need to divide by 100. So here we get the radius as 70 by 100 meters, that is 0.7 meters. Now the area of the sheet is equal to the total square surface area of the tank. So that is equal to 2 pi r into r plus h. And by substituting the values of pi, r and h, we get 7.48 meters square. Now let us see the third problem. A metal pipe is 77 centimeters long. The inner diameter of a cross section is 4 centimeters and the outer diameter being 4.4 centimeters. We need to find its inner curved surface area, outer curved surface area and the total surface area. Here we are talking about the pipe which is in the cylindrical shape, which will be obviously hollow. So it has both the inner surface and the outer surface. So here we are being given with a diameter of the inner radius, that is the white portion which we can see here as 4 centimeters. Therefore, the radius R1 is diameter 1 by 2, which is equal to 2 centimeters. And given the height of the cylinder is 77 centimeters. Now the curved surface area of the inner surface of pipe is given by 2 pi R1H. So by solving this equation, by substituting the value of pi as 22 by 7, R1 as 2 and height as 77, we get 968 centimeters square. Now, we need to find the curved surface area of the outer surface. Given the outer diameter D2 as 4.4 centimeters and the height as 77 centimeters. Therefore, the radius R2 is equal to diameter 2 by 2, that is 4.4 by 2, which is 2.2 centimeters. And given the height of the cylinder, H is equal to 77 centimeters. Therefore, the curved surface area of the outer surface of the pipe is given by 2 pi R2H. In the similar fashion, by substituting the value of pi as 22 by 7 and R2 value, which we got as 2.2 and height is 77 centimeters, we get 1064.8 centimeters square. Here, we need to find the total surface area, which is equal to the curved surface area of the inner cylinder plus curved surface area of the outer cylinder plus area of the base, that is the orange portion plus area of the top. which is also the orange portion which is on the top. So here we can see the orange portion. This is nothing but the area of the top, and this will be the same at the bottom also. So we need to add this area twice. So here the area of the top will be equal to the area of the circle with radius 2.2 minus the area of the circle with radius 2 centimeters. That is pi r2 square minus pi r1 square. So here by substituting the values of pi as 22/7 and r2 as 2.2 square and r1 square as 2 square, we get the value of 2.64 centimeter square. So the total surface area is equal to the curved surface area of the inner cylinder plus curved surface area of the outer cylinder plus 2 into area of base. That is area of top base plus area of bottom base. Therefore, it is 968 plus 1064.8 plus 2 into 2.64, which gives us 2038.08 centimeter square. Therefore, the total surface area of the cylindrical pipe is 2038.08 centimeter square. Now, coming to the fourth problem, the diameter of the roller is 84 centimeters and its length is 120 centimeters. It takes 500 complete revolution to move once over the level a playground. We need to find the area of the playground in meter square. So here, given the roller in the shape having the diameter 84 centimeters and height 140 centimeters like this, what we see in this particular figure. So the roller is in the form of cylinder. Now, radius is equal to diameter by 2, that is 84 by 2, which is 42 centimeters. Now the area of the roller is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder, which is 2 pi r h. By substituting the values of pi r and h, we get it as 31680 centimeter square. So here the area of one revolution is equal to area of roller is equal to 31680 centimeter square. Now the area of 500 revolutions is equal to 500 into 31680 centimeter square. So area of the playground is equal to 1584000 centimeter square. Now we need to convert this into meter square. So to convert centimeters into meters, we need to divide it by 100, but we have centimeter square. So it becomes 1584000 into 1/100 into 1/100 meter square, which is equal to 1584 meter square. Now let us see the fifth problem. That is, a cylinder pillar is 50 centimeters in diameter and 3.5 meters in height. We need to find the cost of painting the curved surface of the pillar at the rate of rupees 12.50 per meter square. So here in this problem, we are given a cylindrical pillar like shown in this particular figure with a diameter of 50 centimeters and height 3.5 meters. Now we need to find the cost of painting the curved surface area. So the pillar is in the shape of cylinder. So the curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h. And the height of the cylindrical pillar is 3.5 meters. So here, substituting the values of pi r and h, we get the solution. Here we can clearly note that the rate is given in meter square. So the diameter need to be converted into meters. So radius is equal to diameter by 2. That is 50 by 2 is equal to 25 centimeters. So to convert into meters, we need to divide it by 100. So we get radius as 0.25 meters. Now the curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h. By substituting the values of pi r and h, we get 5.5 meters square. Now, let us find the cost of painting. So, given the cost for painting 1 meter square area is rupees 12.50. So, the cost for painting 5.5 meter square area is equal to rupees 5.5 into 12.50, which is rupees 68.75. Therefore, the cost of painting the CSA of a pillar is rupees 68.75. Now, let us go to the sixth problem. Curved surface area of a right circular cylinder is 4.4 meter square. If the radius of the base of the cylinder is 0.7 meters, we need to find its height. So, here we are given the curved surface area of the cylinder and radius of base of the cylinder, and we need to find the height. Now, let us suppose the cylinder like this, with the height being h, and the radius of the base of the cylinder r is equal to 0.7 meters. So, curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h, that is 4.4 meter square is equal to 2 pi r h. Substituting the values of pi and r and solving the equation, we get h is equal to 1 meter. Therefore, the height of the cylinder is 1 meter. Now, let us see the seventh problem. The inner diameter of a circular well is 3.5 meters. It is 10 meters deep. We need to find its inner curved surface area and cost of plastering this curved surface at a rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So, here in this problem, we are given a circular well whose diameter is 3.5 meters and height 10 meters, and we need to find the inner curved surface area. So, here curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h. Now, let us calculate the radius r. R is equal to diameter by 2, that is 3.5 by 2, that is 1.75 meters, and height is 10 meters. So, the curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into 1.75 into 10. By solving, we get 110 meters square. Now, the cost for Now, we need to find the cost of plastering the curved surface area at a rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So, 1 meter square costs rupees 40. So, 110 meter square costs rupees 110 into 40, that is rupees 4400. Therefore, the cost of plastering the curved surface area of the well is rupees 4400. Let us see the eighth problem. In a hot water heating system, there is a cylindrical pipe of length 28 meters and diameter 5 centimeters. We need to find the total radiating surface in the system. So, here given us a water heating, in that there is a cylinder pipe whose length is 28 meters and diameter 55 centimeters. Now, we need to find the total radiating surface. Therefore, the cylinder pipe radiates from the curved surface area and not from the ends. Therefore, we need to find the curved surface area of the cylinder whose height is 28 meters and radius is equal to diameter by 2, that is 5 by 2 centimeters is equal to 2.5 centimeters. Converting to meters, we get 0.025 meters. Therefore, the total radiating surface of system is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder, which is 2 pi r h, and we get 4.4 meter square by substituting the values of pi r and h. Now, let us see the ninth problem. Find the lateral or curved surface area of the closed cylindrical petrol storage tank, that is 4.2 meters in diameter and 4.5 meters height, and how much steel was actually used if 1/12 of the steel actually used was wasted in making the tank. So here we are given a cylindrical petrol tank whose diameter is 4.2 and height is 4.5 meters. So first we need to find the curved surface area. Curved surface area is equal to 2 pi r h. H given as 4.5 meters. And radius is diameter by 2, that is 4.2 by 2 meters, that is 2.1 meters. Now the curved surface area, which is equal to 2 pi r h, by substituting the values of pi as 22 by 7, r as 2.1 and h as 4.5, we get 59.4 meters square. Now we need to find how much steel is required to make this tank given 1 by 12th of the steel is being wasted. So now we need to make the tank. So we need to use the steel on curved surface area, top and bottom of the tank. So we need to find the total surface area. So here to find the total surface area, total surface area of the tank is equal to 2 pi r into r plus h. Now by substituting the value of pi as 22 by 7 and r as 2.1 meters and h as 4.5 meters, we get 87.12 meters square. Now we need to find how much steel is being used. Now let us assume that the amount of the steel used is x. So amount wasted will be x by 12. So amount of steel used minus amount of steel wasted will give us the total surface area. That is x minus x by 12 is equal to 87.12. That is 11 by 12 x is equal to 87.12. That is x is equal to 12 by 11 into 87.12. So we get x value as 95.04 meter square. Therefore, 95.04 meter square steel was used in actual while making a tank. Now, let us see the next problem, 10th problem. So here in this figure, you see a frame of lampshade. It is to be covered with a decorative cloth. The frame has a base diameter of 20 centimeters and height of 30 centimeters. And a margin of 2.5 centimeters is to be given for folding it over the top and bottom of the frame. Now we need to find how much cloth is required for covering the lampshade. So here we are given a frame of a lampshade whose diameter is 20 centimeters and height is 30 centimeters. If we need to be covered with a decorative cloth whose size is bigger than the frame, so we need to leave a margin of 2.5 centimeters both on top and bottom of the frame. So the height of the particular frame will become h is equal to 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5 centimeters, that is 35 centimeters. Now we need to find the cloth required to cover the frame of a lampshade. Therefore, we need to find the curved surface area, that is 2 pi r h, where h is 35 centimeters and radius is equal to diameter by 2, which is 20 by 2 is equal to 10 centimeters. Now substituting these values in the equation 2 pi r h, we get it as 2 to 0.00 centimeters square. Hence, for covering the lampshade, 2 to 0.00 centimeters square cloth will be required. Now let us see the 11th problem. The students of a Vidyalaya were asked to participate in a competition for making and decorating pen holders in the shape of a cylinder with a base using cardboard. Each pen holder was to be of radius 3 centimeters and height 10.5 centimeters. the vidyalaya was to supply the competitors with a cardboard. If there were 35 competitors, how much cardboard was required to be brought for the competition? So here some students are making a pen holder which is in cylindrical shape, whose radius is 3 cm and height is 10.5 centimeters. So they need to make 35 such pen holders and say how much cardboard is required to prepare them. So this pen holder is open on the top and closed at the bottom. So the surface area of one pen holder is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder plus area of the bottom circle with radius 3 centimeters. That is 2 pi r h plus pi r square. So by substituting the values of pi r and h, solving, we get 22 by 7 into 72 centimeters square. Therefore, the area of the cardboard required for 35 such pen holders is 35 into 22 by 7 into 72, which is 7920 centimeters square. Please try to solve this problem as an assignment. I have given the solution orally. Please try to solve. Thank you. Thank you all.